Hey guys, it's Jessica Nora here with the Rituals for Transformation 108 Day Journey for Your Sacred Life. Today for me was day 9, and this lesson was very insightful as usual, and I'll just hop right into it. If you want to join along with me in the book, I do link the book in the description below, and you can check it out, as I don't usually read the whole lesson, but I will read a little bit of this one because it sort of ties into how the meditation went for me. So the title of this one is, I Delight in Moving, Stretching, and Working My Body. And one line that really popped out for me says, probably you rarely need to chop wood, carry water, climb trees in the course of managing your everyday life. So basically, this talks about a little bit about how in the past, people would get exercise and move their body just as a part of daily life and their chores they had to do just to maintain their lifestyle. And now we have it easy in this day and age. We don't have to chop wood necessarily for a fire or carry our water. You know, things like that that we may take for granted, but also takes a toll on our body because now we have to go out and artificially exercise, go to the gym, or make an effort to keep our bodies moving. And for me, this was sort of an eye-opening experience because I have had to do a little bit of both. Also in the book, it says you may stop exercising out of obligation and figure out what you delight in. So these two things were the topic of my meditation this morning. And the first thing that came to me was on a recent trip to Morocco, I noticed that most of the folks who lived there, they ate a good amount. I stayed with the family for a while and we ate well, but really no one was overweight, but they did have a little more of a task heavy life. So for instance, you know, like washing the clothes, it wasn't in a washing machine like what we have here. We hit the button, you actually had to do some, you know, labor with it. It was a little more involved. There was a washboard and things like that that you would use. Also, you know, just making the food and the bread was more involved. There wasn't people really, I mean, of course these things do exist in Morocco, but where I was staying, you don't necessarily just put it in the microwave and hit the button. Even the bread was made from the grains all the way to the finished product. So there was more things involved in the daily life and the chores and the routine that made things, you had a little more physical expenditure to do your daily life, which I think definitely leads to the health and fitness of the people that live like that because they're all thin. No one was like overweight or heavy. Everyone seemed very healthy. So I think that definitely makes a difference. And I was thinking maybe it's beneficial for us as a culture, you know, in America or anywhere else to start maybe doing some things the old ways, you know, like our grandparents did maybe, instead of taking the easy way out, maybe do some things a little more by hand. I don't know, it just made me think about, you know, push lawnmowers, how they used to not be electric. And I saw a guy the other day pushing one of the little lawnmowers that just cuts as you push. I'm sure that's a better exercise than a riding lawnmower. Things like that just made me think of it. Also, it made me think back to when I was doing the van life, which I've talked a little bit about on here, like traveling in my van. And when I was doing that, I actually had a little bit of the, you know, a little more of a manual experience there because I wasn't plugging into anything. I was basically off the grid. So I had to do things like get my water. I had to go get the containers and fill it up and, you know, carry it back and forth. And that was heavy. And it seemed like a hassle at the time, but I still think back on it as a fond memory. Also, I know this is going to sound crazy, but like I had a portable toilet in the van and I would have to take the toilet and dump it and clean it and things like that that you don't have to do in a house. You know, and also just for me, because I was, you know, in a camper van, I had to go and every day find a place to shower. There was a lot more thinking and thought and effort involved in that way of living. And it actually gave me, you know, in some ways a sense of routine and purpose, and obviously I'm sure it gave me a little bit of a physical exercise carrying those heavy things around. So it just sort of made me think on that a little bit and how maybe it would be nice to have a balance and a little more of a, to try not to take the easy way out all the time is what I was thinking to myself. Maybe I should try to do some things, you know, where if there's a manual way of doing it to maybe lean towards that. Also, like I said, the other part of this was trying to figure out what you enjoy doing that would delight you as an exercise. And for me, one thing I really enjoy doing is riding my bike. So for me, that's always my go-to when I want to do exercise or I want to get a workout in. I love riding my bike. That's something that I will do for like hours every day if I could. So for me, that's sort of my go-to. And I enjoy hiking and walking too. So that's another go-to for me. Some things, I just don't like being in a gym. I have a gym membership, but I rarely ever go because I don't like just being in a gym on a stationary machine. So for me, that's something that I have to like make myself do. It feels like a chore and I end up not doing it for that reason. But I will go for a walk in nature or anything that involves being outside. I love that, especially my bike, like I said. So for me, that's something I can do that makes me excited to move my body and get out and do a little bit of exploring. So anyway, that's what I got out of this lesson today. When I do my meditation tonight on the same lesson, I will link what comes out of that meditation in the comments below. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please like and subscribe and let me know. This was day 9, and from what I understand, this is the last of the body section, I think. So we're going to be moving into new sections after this. Anyway, thank you so much for watching and have an awesome day. Bye!